Andorra. Andorra is unofficially the Principality of Andorra, Catalan, Principat d'Andorra, also called the Principality of the Valleys of Andorra, Catalan, Principat de les Valls d'Andorra, is a sovereign landlocked microstate on the Iberian Peninsula, in the eastern Pyrenees, bordered by France to the north and Spain to the south. Believed to have been created by Charlemagne, Andorra was ruled by the Count of Urgell until 988, when it was transferred to the Roman Catholic Diocese of Urgell. The present principality was formed by a charter in 1278. It is known as a principality as it is a diarchy headed by two princes, the Catholic Bishop of Urgell in Catalonia, Spain, and the President of the French Republic. Andorra is the sixth smallest nation in Europe, having an area of 468 square kilometers, 181 square miles, and a population of approximately 77,006. The Andorran people are a Romance ethnic group of originally Catalan descent. Andorra is the 16th smallest country in the world by land and the 11th smallest by population. Its capital, Andorra la Vella, is the highest capital city in Europe, at an elevation of 1,023 meters (3,356 feet) above sea level. The official language is Catalan, but Spanish, Portuguese, and French are also commonly spoken. Tourism in Andorra sees an estimated 10.2 million visitors annually. Andorra is not a member of the European Union, but the euro is its official currency. It has been a member of the United Nations since 1993. In 2013, Andorra had the highest life expectancy in the world at 81 years, according to the Global Burden of Disease Study. Etymology of Andorra. The origin of the word Andorra is unknown, although several hypotheses have been formulated. The oldest derivation of the word Andorra is from the Greek historian Polybius, the Histories 3, 35:1, who describes the Andusans, an Iberian pre-Roman tribe, as historically located in the valleys of Andorra and facing the Carthaginian army in its passage through the Pyrenees during the Punic Wars. The word Andesini or Andusans may derive from the Basque Handia, whose meaning is big or giant. The Andorran toponymy shows evidence of Basque language in the area. Another theory suggests that the word Andorra may derive from the old word Anora that contains the Basque word ur, water. Another theory suggests that Andorra may derive from Arabic al-Dura, meaning, the forest. When the Arabs and Moors conquered the Iberian Peninsula, the valleys of the High Pyrenees were covered by large tracts of forest, and most of the regions that were not administered by Muslims, because of the geographical difficulty that was presented, received this designation. Other theories suggest that the term derives from the Navarro-Aragonese Andorial, which means land covered with bushes, or scrubland. The folk etymology holds that Charlemagne had named the region as a reference to the biblical Canaanite valley of Endor or Andor, where the Midianites had been defeated, a name bestowed by his heir and son Louis le Debonair after defeating the Moors in the wild valleys of hell. History of Andorra. La Balma de la Marginita, found by archaeologists at San Giulia de Loria, was settled in 9500 BC as a passing place between the two sides of the Pyrenees. The seasonal camp was perfectly located for hunting and fishing by the groups of hunter-gatherers from Ariège and Segre. During the Neolithic Age, a group of people moved to the Valley of Madriu, nowadays natural park located in Escaldes and Gordany declared UNESCO World Heritage Site, as a permanent camp in 6640 BC. The population of the valley grew cereals, raised domestic livestock, and developed a commercial trade with people from the Segre and Occitania. Other archaeological deposits include the tombs of Segude, Ordino, and Facia del Moro, San Giulia de Loria, both dated in 4900-4300 BC as an example of the urn culture in Andorra. The model of small settlements began to evolve to complex urbanism during the Bronze Age. Metallurgical items of iron, ancient coins, and reliquaries can be found in the ancient sanctuaries scattered around the country. The Sanctuary of Roc de les Bruixes, Stone of the Witches, is perhaps the most important archaeological complex of this age in Andorra, located in the parish of Canillo, about the rituals of funerals, ancient scripture and engraved stone murals. 18th to 19th centuries. In 1601 the Tribunal de Courts, High Court of Justice, was created as a result of Huguenot rebellions from France, Inquisition courts coming from Spain and indigenous witchcraft experienced in the country due to the Reformation and Counter-Reformation. With the passage of time, the co-title to Andorra passed to the kings of Navarre. After Henry III of Navarre became king of France, he issued an edict in 1607 that established the head of the French state and the Bishop of Urgell as co-princes of Andorra. During 1617, communal councils formed the content, popular militia or army, to deal with the rise of bandoleros, brigandage, and the Consul de la Terra was defined and structured in terms of its composition, organization and competences current today. Andorra continued with the same economic system that it had during the 12th-14th centuries with a large production of metallurgy, argues, a system similar to Farga Catalana and with the introduction of tobacco circa 1692 and import trade. The Fair of Andorra la Vella was ratified by the co-princes in 1371 and 1448, being the most important annual national festival commercially ever since. Manor House of the Rossell family in Ordino, Casa Rossell, built in 1611. The family also owned the largest ironwork forges in Andorra as Farga Rossell and Farga del Serrat. The country had a unique and experienced guild of weavers, Confraria de Parers y Teixidors, located in Escalds in Gordany, founded in 1604, taking advantage of the thermal waters of the area. By this time, the country was characterized by the social system of programs, wealthy society, and castors, rest of the population with the smaller economic acquisition, deriving from the tradition of Pubilla and Hiru. 3 centuries after its foundation, the Consul de la Terra located its headquarters and the Tribunal de Courts in Casa de la Val in 1702. The manor house built in 1580 served as a noble fortress of the Busquets family. Inside the Parliament was placed the Closet of the Six Keys, Armari de les Six Claws, representative of each Andorran parish and where the Andorran constitution and other documents and laws were kept later on. In both the Reapers' War and the War of the Spanish Succession, the Andorran people, although professing to be a neutral country, supported the Catalans who saw their rights reduced in 1716. The reaction was the promotion of Catalan writings in Andorra, with cultural works such as the Book of Privileges, Libre de Privilegis de 1674, Manual Digest, 1748, by Antony Fitter I Rossell or the Polita Andorra, 1763, by Antony Puig. Politics in Andorra. Andorra is a parliamentary co-principality with the President of France and the Catholic Bishop of Urgell, Catalonia, Spain, as co-princes. This peculiarity makes the President of France, in his capacity as Prince of Andorra, an elected monarch, although he is not elected by a popular vote of the Andorran people. The politics of Andorra take place in a framework of parliamentary representative democracy, whereby the head of government is the chief executive, and of a pluriform multi-party system. The current head of government is Xavier Espit Zamora of the Democrats for Andorra, DA. Executive power is exercised by the government. Legislative power is vested in both government and parliament. The Parliament of Andorra is known as the General Council. The General Council consists of between 28 and 42 councillors. The councillors serve for 4-year terms, and elections are held between the 30th and 40th days following the dissolution of the previous council. Half are elected in equal numbers by each of the 7 administrative parishes, and the other half of the councillors are elected in a single national constituency. 15 days after the election, the councillors hold their inauguration. During this session, the Syndic General, who is the head of the General Council, and the Sub-Syndic General, his assistant, are elected. 8 days later, the Council convenes once more. During this session, the head of government is chosen from among the councillors. Candidates can be proposed by a minimum of 1/5 of the councillors. The Council then elects the candidate with the absolute majority of votes to be head of government. The Syndic General then notifies the co-princes, who in turn appoint the elected candidate as the head of government of Andorra. The General Council is also responsible for proposing and passing laws. Bills may be presented to the Council as private members' bills by 3 of the local parish councils jointly or by at least 1/10 of the citizens of Andorra. Candidates can be proposed by a minimum of 1/5 of the councillors. The council then elects the candidate with the absolute majority of votes to be head of government. The Syndic General then notifies the co-princes, who in turn appoint the elected candidate as the head of government of Andorra. The General Council is also responsible for proposing and passing laws. Bills may be presented to the council as private members' bills by three of the local parish councils jointly or by at least one-tenth of the citizens of Andorra. If the head of government is not satisfied with the council, he may request that the co-princes dissolve the council and order new elections. In turn, the councillors have the power to remove the head of government from office. After a motion of censure is approved by at least one-fifth of the councillors, the council will vote, and if it receives the absolute majority of votes, the head of government is removed. Law and criminal justice. The judiciary is composed of the Magistrates' Court, the Criminal Law Court, the High Court of Andorra, and the Constitutional Court. The High Court of Justice is composed of five judges, one appointed by the head of government, one each by the co-princes, one by the syndic general, and one by the judges and magistrates. It is presided over by the member appointed by the syndic general, and the judges hold office for six-year terms. The magistrates and judges are appointed by the High Court, as is the president of the Criminal Law Court. The High Court also appoints members of the Office of the Attorney General. The Constitutional Court is responsible for interpreting the Constitution and reviewing all appeals of unconstitutionality against laws and treaties. It is composed of four judges, one appointed by each of the co-princes and two by the General Council. They serve eight-year terms. The court is presided over by one of the judges on a two-year rotation, so that each judge at one point will preside over the court. Foreign relations, defense, and security in Andorra. Andorra does not have its own armed forces, although there is a small ceremonial army. Responsibility for defending the nation rests primarily with France and Spain. However, in case of emergencies or natural disasters, the somatint, an alarm, is called, and all able-bodied men between 21 and 60 of Andorran nationality must serve. This is why all Andorrans, and especially the head of each house, usually the eldest able-bodied man of a house, should, by law, keep a rifle, even though the law also states that the police will offer a firearm in case of need. Andorra is a full member of the United Nations, UN, the Organization for Security and Cooperation in Europe, OSCE, and has a special agreement with the European Union, EU. Military in Andorra. Andorra has a small army, which has historically been raised or reconstituted at various dates, but has never in modern times amounted to a standing army. The basic principle of Andorran defense is that all able-bodied men are available to fight if called upon by the sounding of the content. Being a landlocked country, Andorra has no navy. Before World War I, Andorra maintained an armed force of about 600 part-time militiamen under the supervision of a captain, capita or cap de somatint, and a lieutenant, deciner or lieutenant del capita. This body was not liable for service outside the principality and was commanded by two officials, veguers, appointed by France and the Bishop of Urgell. Despite not being involved in any fighting during the First World War, Andorra was technically the longest combatant, as the country was left out of the Versailles Peace Conference, technically remaining at war with Germany from its original declaration of war in 1914 until the 24th of September 1958, when Andorra officially declared peace with Germany. In the modern era, the army has consisted of a very small body of volunteers willing to undertake ceremonial duties. Uniforms and weaponry were handed down from generation to generation within families and communities. The army's role in internal security was largely taken over by the formation of the Police Corps of Andorra in 1931. A brief civil disorder associated with the elections of 1933 led to assistance being sought from the French National Gendarmerie, with a detachment resident in Andorra for 2 months under the command of René Jules Ballard. The Andorran police was reformed in the following year, with 11 soldiers appointed to supervisory roles. The force consisted of six corporals, one for each parish. Although there are currently seven parishes, there were only six until 1978, plus four junior staff officers to coordinate action, and a commander with the rank of major. It was the responsibility of the six corporals, each in his own parish, to be able to raise a fighting force from among the able-bodied men of the parish. Today, a small, 12-man ceremonial unit remains the only permanent section of the content, but all able-bodied men remain technically available for military service, with a requirement for each family to have access to a firearm. A shotgun per household is unregulated. Rifles and pistols require a license. The army has not fought for more than 700 years, and its main responsibility is to present the flag of Andorra at official ceremonial functions. According to Mark Forney Molnay, Andorra's military budget is strictly from voluntary donations and the availability of full-time volunteers. In more recent times, there has only been a general emergency call to the Popular Army of Somadant during the floods of 1982 in the Catalan Pyrenees, where 12 citizens perished in Andorra, to help the population and establish a public order along with the local police units. Physical geography of Andorra. Due to its location in the eastern Pyrenees mountain range, Andorra consists predominantly of rugged mountains, the highest being the Coma Pedrosa at 2,942 meters (9,652 feet), and the average elevation of Andorra is 1,996 meters (6,549 feet). These are dissected by three narrow valleys in a Y shape that combine into one as the mainstream. The Gran Valira River leaves the country for Spain at Andorra's lowest point of 840 meters or 2,756 feet. Andorra's land area is 468 square kilometers, 181 square miles. Phytogeographically, Andorra belongs to the Atlantic European province of the Circumboreal region within the Boreal Kingdom. According to the WWF, the territory of Andorra belongs to the ecoregion of Pyrenees conifer and mixed forests. Climate in Andorra. Andorra has alpine, continental and oceanic climates, depending on altitude. Its higher elevation means there is, on average, more snow in winter and it is slightly cooler in summer. The diversity of landmarks, the different orientation of the valleys and the irregularity relief typical of the Mediterranean climates make the country have a great diversity of microclimates that hinder the general dominance of the high mountain climate. The great differences of altitude in the minimum and maximum points, together with the influence of a Mediterranean climate, develop the climate of the Andorran Pyrenees. When in precipitation, a global model characterized by convective and abundant rains can be defined during spring and summer, which can last until autumn. May, June and August are usually the rainiest months. In winter, however, it is less rainy, except in the highlands, subject to the influence of fronts from the Atlantic, which explains the great amount of snowfall in the Andorran mountains. The temperature regime is characterized, broadly, by a temperate summer and a long and cold winter, in accordance with the mountainous condition of the principality. Sports in Andorra. Andorra is famous for the practice of winter sports. Andorra has the largest territory of ski slopes in the Pyrenees, 3,100 hectares and about 350 kilometers of slopes, and two ski resorts. Gran Valira is the largest and most popular resort. Other popular sports played in Andorra include football, rugby union, basketball, and roller hockey. For roller hockey, Andorra usually plays in CERH Euro Cup and in FIRS Roller Hockey World Cup. In 2011, Andorra was the host country to the 2011 European League Final Eight. The country is represented in association football by the Andorra national football team. The team gained its first competitive win in a World Cup qualifier on the 11th of October 2019, in a European Championship qualifier against Moldova. Football is governed in Andorra by the Andorran Football Federation, founded in 1994. It organizes the national competitions of association football, Primera Divisió, Copa Constitucio and Supercopa, and futsal. Andorra was admitted to UEFA and FIFA in the same year, 1996. FC Andorra, a club based in Andorra La Vella founded in 1942, compete in the Spanish Football League system. Rugby is a traditional sport in Andorra, mainly influenced by the popularity in southern France. The Andorra National Rugby Union team, nicknamed Els Izzards, plays on the international stage in rugby union and rugby sevens. VPC Andorra 15 is a rugby team based in Andorra La Vella actually playing in the French Championship. Basketball popularity has increased in the country since the 1990s when the Andorran team BC Andorra played in the top league of Spain, Liga ACB. After 18 years, the club returned to the top league in 2014. Other sports practiced in Andorra include cycling, volleyball, judo, Australian rules football, handball, swimming, gymnastics, tennis, and motorsports. In 2012, Andorra raised its first national cricket team and played a home match against the Dutch Fellowship of Fairly Odd Places Cricket Club, the first match played in the history of Andorra at an altitude of 1,300 meters, 4,300 feet. Andorra first participated at the Olympic Games in 1976. The country has appeared in every Winter Olympic Games since 1976. Andorra competes in the Games of the Small States of Europe, being twice the host country in 1991 and 2005. As one of the Catalan countries, Andorra is home to a team of castellers or Catalan human tower builders. The castellers d'Andorra, based in the town of Santa Coloma d'Andorra, are recognized by the Coordinadora de Cols Castellers de Catalunya, the governing body of castells. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, click on like button. If you want to watch more videos like this, click on the subscription button below. It's free subscription.